And start now. Hello everyone, I am Dr. Preeti Sharma, Senior Consultant Pediatrician at KIMS Cuddles, Kondapur, Hyderabad. Today I will be talking about nocturnal enuresis, also known as, commonly known as bedwetting. Now, when exactly is bedwetting a problem? I know parents are very distressed when children pass urine in the night, they have to wake up, change the child, change all the beddings. But when is it a problem? Obviously, a one-year-old child is going to pass urine in the night. A two-year-old will also pass urine in the night. So when should you start worrying about bedwetting? What changes can you make about it? And when should you visit a pediatrician if bedwetting is persistent? Now, starting about control of the bladder and control of bedwetting, most of the children can start toilet training by the time they are 15 to 18 months of age. But all children have their different pace of being toilet trained. So firstly, when the child is being toilet trained, you should not force them to sit on a pot or to pass urine in the pot. Some children may be toilet trained at 15 months, some may not be toilet trained till 2.5 years also. So first thing which comes is daytime control of the urinary bladder. So daytime your baby will start indicating that the baby wants to go for urine. Then slowly in nighttime child will gain control over the bladder. Sometimes in the beginning children may pass urine 2-3 times in the night. Then slowly it may become 1 or 2 times in the night. Then slowly with time it becomes less than 2 times in a week. So around 20% of the children at 5 years of age will also have bedwetting at least 2 or more times in a week. Out of this, 10% of the children will also have bedwetting more than 2 times in a week by the age of 7 years also. And some children, around the remaining 5% of the children, will have bedwetting even when they are 10 years of age, more than 2 times in a week. So essentially till 5 years of age, you should not worry about bedwetting at all. Please don't make a big deal out of it. Don't badger the child, oh, you're still bedwetting. Till 5 years, there is absolutely nothing to be done. Just slowly encourage your child to go and pass urine in the toilet. You can have some reward system for children less than 5 years. If one night the child does not pass urine in the bed or tells you about urine, then you can give 1 star. When a child has 5 stars, then you can give a small reward. So this kind of positive reinforcement you can have. In fact, till 6 to 7 years also we don't worry about bedwetting. But if your child is bedwetting almost every single night, your child is having problem during daytime also. Like some children, even when they are 5 years old, they are not able to control their urine in daytime also. Frequent accidents. See, occasional accident for a 5-year-old, 6-year-old is not such a big thing. He or she is busy playing with friends or doing something and they are so excited. So a little bit urine leaks, that's acceptable. But if your child is having frequent accidents, almost every day, every other day, your child ends up passing urine in daytime without their knowledge. If child is passing urine almost every night, if because of this bedwetting, the child is having emotional issues, the child is feeling anxiety, the child is feeling insecure, then only at the age of 5 to 6 or 7 years, you should approach the pediatrician for this. Otherwise, till 7 years, there's nothing to worry. Most of the children slowly will regain control of the bladder. One thing which you need to notice if your child is still bedwetting is if your child has constipation. A 4-year-old child, 5-year-old child with constipation, even though they have good bladder control, they may keep passing urine in the bed. Reason being, so the urinary bladder is in front of the rectum. So if the rectum is where the motion is, so if a child has constipation, the rectum will be full and it will push on the bladder. So the bladder will not be able to hold much urine and the child will inadvertently pass urine even during daytime. So constipation needs to be corrected at any age. That is not exactly related to bedwetting, but it may contribute to bedwetting. So any age child having constipation, passing hard stools, you have to consult your pediatrician. But per se for bedwetting till 6 to 7 years, nothing to worry. only if severe symptoms, like I told, daytime wetting, nighttime, every night a 5-year-old child is wetting, then you may consider consulting a pediatrician. Now, coming to children more than 6 to 7 years of age who are still bedwetting, then yes, you should definitely fix an appointment with your pediatrician. During COVID time, if you are not able to go for a physical consultation, you can book an online consultation also. So, in these age children, we go for a few basic tests. Firstly, we want to make sure that the child does not have any urinary infection. So, a basic CUE and urine culture, your pediatrician may advise for your child. And we may do an ultrasound of the bladder, the kidneys, the ureters to see. Sometimes we have picked up kidney-related problems which may be causing the child to lose control over the bladder. But these are rare. Most commonly, with time, the child will start passing urine on, you know, on his, in his consciousness, he or she will wake up in the night. Now, there are two types of nocturnal enuresis or bedwetting. One is primary nocturnal enuresis, means the child never gained control over his or her bladder. Like, child never learned to control his or her urine in the night time. So, in this case, nothing to worry. Wait till 6 or 7 years. 7 years, consult a pediatrician. You get these basic tests done. But something, there is something known as secondary nocturnal enuresis. Now, what is secondary nocturnal enuresis? Now, these are the children who have gained control over their bladder, say, by 4 years or 5 years. There is no bedwetting. And suddenly, at 7 years, the child is again bedwetting. Or at 6 years or 5 years, again, a child had gained control, who had stopped bedwetting, again starts bedwetting. In this case, even for younger children, we have to rule out infection and we have to consider other problems. There are many psychological, emotional problems which may be contributing to this. For example, death of a close ones, a grandparent passed away, change of location, you shifted from, say, Bangalore to Hyderabad, child is not getting adjusted. Fight amongst parents. Parents are having continuous tiffs, fighting amongst themselves. Parents are undergoing separation. Or just simply child is feeling very low, is having low self-esteem. So in this case, the child may need a psychologist evaluation first if it is secondary nocturnal enuresis. For primary, as I said, you can just wait. Now, coming to simple tips, supposing there is no urine infection, there is no kidney problem, the constipation we have corrected. Still, your child at 7 years is passing urine at night in the bed. Firstly, nocturnal enuresis by itself, every year, like supposing out of 100 children who are bedwetting at 7 years of age, every year 15 children will stop bedwetting. So naturally also they will gain more control over the bladder. But few things which you can do. Firstly, starting with the intake of liquids. One common thing which parents do is they feel if we will give less water, less liquids, then the child will form less urine and less chances of bedwetting. Now this is a very wrong thinking. Children need adequate water. In fact, what happens is some parents will start stressing about bedwetting right from the child time the child is 5 years. So they will start withholding more of water or more of liquids. Then what happens as a compensation, because the child will be relatively dehydrated because they had less water, just at night time the child may feel more thirsty and just before going to sleep the child may drink one or two glasses of water. So that will be a problem. So adequate water is important. It's not important. It is very, very important. Otherwise, urine infections, constipation, all these problems will also increase. So for children around, anyway, still 5 years, we don't bother about it. But still, to give you the information, 2 to 5 years old children should have at least 1 liter. 5 to 10 years children should have at least 1.5 liter. And more than 10 years children should have 1.5 to 2 liters of water. So this water you should distribute throughout the day. But before sleep time, supposing your child goes to sleep at 10 o'clock in the night, then the child should not have any water after 8 o'clock. Maybe 1 or 2 sips is fine, but predominantly no water intake after 8 p.m. in the night. So 2 hours before sleeping. If your child sleeps at 11 o'clock, then last water the child can have is at 9 o'clock. But throughout the day, your child should have this good 1 to 2 liters as per age of water. Few drinks which are not at all recommended Even otherwise, we don't recommend it, but especially a child who's suffering with this problem of bedwetting, for those children, you should not give any caffeinated drinks. No tea, no coffee, no cold drinks. These drinks are strictly prohibited for children who are having this bedwetting issue. So this is about their liquid intake and how to stop the liquids 2 hours before sleep time. Now coming to in between the night. Now what most parents do is, supposing the child is bedwetting at around 1 o'clock. So the parent will get up. He or she will go wake up the child at say 12:30 or 1 o'clock and make the child pass urine. This will not help your problem. This will not help in solving the problem. What will help is if the child herself or himself wakes up and then goes to the washroom, to the bathroom. So what you can do is, supposing the child is passing urine say at 1 o'clock every night, you put an alarm for the child at 12:45. Okay, let the child only wake up, close the alarm and go and pass urine. So slowly this will come in the habit of the child to go and pass urine in the bathroom. But if you are going to keep waking up the child, this will not help. There are certain alarm beds also available, but in India they are not available as of now, but in Western countries they are, as and when if you get them in India. So what these beds have is, as soon as the baby passes, as soon as the child passes urine, they will judge the wetness and the alarm will go off. The alarm will be in the mattress and that will go off. So in between urinating, only the child will get up because of the alarm, and he or she can finish urinating in the bathroom, and slowly then they will get in the habit of waking up at that particular time. Now the biggest problem is, especially for older children, once they are 9 years, 10 years, parents want quick solution once they come to the pediatrician. If they come to me today, if I'm telling them to restrict water intake before bedtime and to make the child get up by alarm, if the child is still bedwetting within 1 or 2 weeks, they will get very upset about it and they will come back to me saying that this is not working. These things take time. Any behavioral or lifestyle change which you will make for the child to show some effect, it will take at least 4 to 6 weeks. So please be patient and also keep giving the child positive reinforcement. Now positive reinforcement should not be when the child stops bedwetting. It should be for the correct behavior. For example, today your child drank 1.5 liters throughout the day till 8 o'clock, and then before sleeping he or she did not drink water. So for that you should get a star or some point system you can have. Similarly, if your child puts an alarm and wakes up, now even after putting the alarm and waking up, there may be an accident, but at least your child is doing that. So you give them positive reinforcement. Lot of parents I find shame the children, they make them feel very bad. Please don't do it. It will make your problem worse. Forget about the psychological impact on children, but it will make their bedwetting problem worse. They will feel insecure. They will feel ashamed. They will start having anxiety. They will have low self-esteem. So please don't go for it. Many parents come and ask me, we have heard there are certain medicines. Why don't you use that? Why don't you give the child the medicines? Medicines are not the first option. As I said, by 10 years, 5% of normal kids are bedwetting. So it is not, it may be a problem for you, but for the child's health, it's not a problem. So medicines we use only for older children above 10 years. Or if you need some short-term relief, for example, you are going for a wedding in the family. And, you know, obviously that time it will be very uncomfortable if an old child, 9-year, 10-year-old boy or girl is bedwetting and then you have to change the sheets, wash the sheets. Then yes, there is a medicine known as desmopressin that you can consult your pediatrician. So we can use that. Desmopressin also we use for older kids also if these methods are just not working and the bedwetting is really affecting the child's day-to-day behavior, self-esteem is being affected. And we do go for these drugs. But medicine is the absolute last option. Firstly, so this is a short talk. I'll just summarize it quickly for you. First and foremostly, bedwetting is normal. 99.99% children have no issues with bedwetting till 7 years, 6 years, absolutely nothing to worry. From the age of 5 to 7 years, if severe symptoms like daytime symptoms or daily bedwetting or child is feeling low self-esteem or some social reason, then yes, you can consult your pediatrician. Limit the fluids before bedtime, but daytime good hydration. Make sure child passes urine every 3 to 4 hours, and especially before going to sleep, child should go and pass urine. Even if the child, supposing, is going to bed at 10 o'clock and the child passes urine at 9 o'clock, still you insist that at 10 o'clock you go and empty your bladder, and then only you will be allowed to sleep. Your alarm system works very well, but provided the child is switching off the alarm, not you. And after the alarm system is positive reinforcement, giving some marks, some points for this good behavior by the child. And lastly, we can opt for the medication. And any of these behavior systems, give them at least 2 months to show some improvement. Don't expect immediate results. But yes, before any of this, if your child is having bedwetting, do visit your pediatrician, get the basic test done. We have had children come to us for 10 years with bedwetting, and then we do an ultrasound. The child has a major kidney problem, which was missed. Now, if the same child came at 6 years or 7 years because of the severe bedwetting, then this disease could have picked up. These are rare, but for any child with bedwetting, a basic initial assessment for kidney problems, urine infections, constipations, any psychological issues, this can be done by a pediatrician. Hope this helps with your child. Thank you.